Welcome back to my channel. So, I have some pretty kick-ass news to tell you guys. Like, I'm so excited. If you follow me on Facebook, well, I haven't said anything on Instagram, but if you follow me on Facebook, you already know. So, I am gonna get back on Dupixent, you guys. I'm so freaking excited. So, if you do not know my whole situation with the Dupixent and why I'm on it, like, I have eczema, like, motherfucker, like, hello. So, I started the Dupixent originally December 6th of 2017. Last year, right before the year ended, and my dad was working for, I don't know if I could say the company, so I'm not going to. If you know what it is, shush. But my dad was like working still, he just retired because basically the whole company pulled the managers because he was call manager at night, and they basically pulled him in the office and were like, okay, we can either demote you to assistant manager because they were taking that call manager position away completely, or we can just give you a severance. And he was like, you know what, I'm 65, just give me the severance. But with that happening, I lost my insurance because I was dependent on his insurance. And so I haven't had Dupixent since like March, I believe March 28th was my last shot. March 28th, 2018 was my last shot. Because every time you do the Dupixent, you have to do it at a different spot on your body. So you have to keep track of it. So I have it all on my phone, and I think my last shot was March 28th. Today is January 30th, 2019. So it's been a hot minute. I've fought tooth and nail with Medicaid. They've given me such a hard time about it. They've made me try multiple medications that have obviously all failed. They made me go find, they were like, either fail Elidel or Protopic, and I already failed Elidel. I'm like, I already had the Elidel. So they're like, okay, go find the receipt from when you picked it up. Just so that, of course, because I would totally be lying about my fucking eczema medication that I need. Like, okay. So I had to call, I think it was prescribed at Walgreens, like 2-3 years ago now. I had to call them, and I was like, I have a prescription that they're asking for that I picked up like 3 years ago, 2016. So he's like, oh, our records only go back 18 months. Fuck my life. I had to call the people in Danville, Illinois. And they're like an hour or two behind me. I'm in Florida, so East Coast time. And I had to wait for their office to open, and then I had to keep calling my dermatologist's office back and forth because they close at 12 o'clock on Friday. So I'm like, by the time these people open 8 o'clock their time, it's gonna be 12, 1 o'clock my time, and my office is gonna be closed. So I like kept calling them back and forth. And they're like, we need a signed thing from your doctor and this and that. And it was a whole pain in the ass. And they didn't approve me for the Dupixent. I have two denials, but the manufacturer of Dupixent said that if I have three denials, they'll just give it to me for free, because literally that medicine is $3,000 a pop. Like, I have people from other like countries like Brazil be like, oh, I wish I could get on it. It's so expensive. Like, it's expensive here too. Like, sorry, like, I don't want to sound bitchy, but like, everybody thinks like the United States is just like the land of fix everybody's problems. And it's not. Like, that medicine is literally $3,000 a pop, and I cannot afford that. The medicine that they did approve me for, though, I don't know why I brought it in here, but I know I've showed it in other videos. It's the Dermasmooth oil, and it's literally, like, the generic is $4. The name brand is, like, $200 a pop, so they approved me for the name brand that was $200, and I was like, yeah, that's hallelujah. So I've just been using that and the white. If you look at my last video, I've just been using that and the, I can't think of what that big white jar is right now, but that too. Everything's kind of flared up right now because the weather is insane. Like, it has been so, it's like 50 degrees today. Like, well, that's not cold for most people, but for Florida, it is ridiculous. Like, show you guys my face. This has been really bad, and I've been trying to nip this in the ass because when this gets flared up, like, all through here, it flakes into my eyes, and like, I'll wake up in the morning and my eyes will be oozing and crusting and just gross. Like, oh my god. Like, not fun. And then everything else, oh, it's just itchy. My back, like, I can't deal with this. I'm so excited just to be done with all these fucking flares, because like, I can't anymore. I feel like my body is just like, okay, we can't do this anymore. No, not today. What else was I gonna tell you guys about that? So I should be back on maybe by March. I'm not sure because my mom got a new job with insurance, but she used to pay for the insurance for me, and she was like, I don't even care about that. I'm like, we can eat fucking beans. Like, I don't care. Like, as long as I have insurance, like, I do not care. Just get the insurance. And then, so it should be like March maybe, I don't know, but like, I'm so glad it'll be like during the summer, because during the summer this year, I was fucking miserable, and especially with all the swimming, people don't think about the fact that chlorine dries out your skin like a motherfucker, like so bad, and I was so sunburned, and oh my god, okay. Black people do get sunburned, just to clarify that. Some people say we don't, but we do. Like, we have skin, we're humans, it's just a little darker, okay? But other than that, toothpicks and stuff, I am also trying to move the fuck out of the place that I'm in right now because, one, it is so freaking expensive, it's ridiculous. Like, it's getting up into the thousands, and I'm like, no, no. Like, we're not doing this. And then, second thing is, my neighbor, not across the hall, but catty corner, is a Vietnam vet, and he fell as high as the Empire State Building out of an airplane and landed on his head. So he has brain damage, and he has been flipping out. The police, he got arrested Friday or Saturday, and the police, like, he was flipping out on the police. He was starting arguments with multiple people because he cannot drive. He will walk down to any of the bars, like, down here and drink all day long. And he went into one place up here and started an argument. Of course, the cops came and got him and said that they took his $400 or $500 bulletproof vest. And he lives with his mom, and she's like 82. I love her to death. And she was like, he spent like $400 on that. I'm like, what does he need that for? Like, hello. Like, we live in a gated community. Like, who needs that? But yeah, if I do a move, like, I'll do a house tour, apartment tour, whatever. And if you want to see, oh, and I was going to say something about my ears. They're fine if I freaked anybody out on that stretching video. I'm sorry. They're cool. Like, they're fine. I love these plugs so much. But, they don't get flared up unless, like, I use some shit that I wasn't supposed to on my ears. And by the way, I changed everything to cruelty-free. I found a system that was cruelty-free. I use the Tattoo Goo system now. So if you want me to do a video using that whole, like, system that I have, just let me know. Girl, I got you. So yeah, that's basically the updates that I have for you guys right now. I love you guys so much. Stay true, stay weird, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.